Our scripture today invites us to see the image of the kingdom of God like a mustard seed. This tiniest of seeds bursts forth with life and grows into a mighty tree, so broad and beautiful that the birds of the air can nest and find a home in its branches. In preparing for this service today, I turned on my 11th grade AP bio brain and wondered, what does it take for a seed to become a plant? Now, full disclosure, I got a D, maybe a D plus in both high school bio and college bio, so take the science for what you will. But I hear that in order for seeds to grow into plants, they need to crack open. Their shells literally need to split so that a shoot can break forth from the ground. And in order for that breaking to take place, they need the right combination of warmth and protection and pressure and nutrients. All those right amounts mixed together can break open a seed that shoots up into a plant that becomes the mustard tree. In our scripture, we hear Jesus talking about the mustard tree as this welcome addition to the garden, when in reality, a mustard seed is often seen as invasive or a nuisance to gardeners. These mustard seeds don't stay in one place. They spread out and they go wherever they please. As the mustard plant grows, they flower, and the seeds in the flower catch the wind and spread throughout the garden or the yard or the field. They grow where they will. They blow where they will. And once introduced, the mustard seed is a hard plant to get rid of, which is probably why it's a perfect metaphor for the kingdom of heaven, I'd imagine. Once broken open, once introduced, the love and movement of God cannot be and will not be stopped. The unfurling kingdom of heaven will not be weeded out. It will not be stamped down. It will just continue to grow. We may be asking, what is the kingdom of heaven? It's kind of a weird image. Dear ones, it is both in the here and the hereafter. The kingdom of heaven is the movement that brings us closer to each other, closer to God. It is the unfurling justice and compassion of God in this life, in the next life, in this day, and in all the days to come. And each of us, each child of God, belongs in the kingdom of heaven. Each of us needs the protection, the warmth, the nutrients, the flow of water in order to survive, in order to break open to what we could be. We are not so different from the mustard seed. Each of us have these hard shells around us from time to time. How could we not? In a world where we are constantly seeking protection, where we lean into scarcity, where tribalism has kept us separate and isolated and afraid, we feel like we might need that protective layer. Who among us hasn't put up walls before? Hasn't walled ourselves off from what could be, from our neighbor, from our friends, from the people God has made us to be? These shells, they're made of our expectations, our plans, our prejudices. These shells are made of our carefully lined gardens, the things we think are going to happen, the plans that we've made. They're made of our traditions and our scarcity mindsets and our fears. And yet, we are invited to break open and away from the hard shells around us. When we come together each week, when we came together this morning in our opening prayer, we take time to breathe and to recognize that we belong with each other, that these hard shells, these barriers we've put up, they're not really for us. They aren't really helping us. We take time to shed all that we've carried with us, all the places we have been, and we're invited to release our hold and our hard exteriors in order to be prepared for the breaking open that can happen in worship. We might not guess from looking at tiny mustard seeds. If you've seen them, they're so small. They're so, so small. You can buy them at Market Basket, I'm pretty sure, actually. You might not guess that they could grow into something so much bigger, that they could crack open and become this huge plant, this huge tree, that this tiny seed could provide shelter for others, could set down roots in the depths of the earth. We might not guess from looking at any one of us. That we are connected, that our seeds are breaking open, that we are capable of growing into more than what we are behind our shells, behind our hard exteriors. This morning, beloved, here in this household of faith, we have a chance to crack open our hard shells and to unfurl into tall plants to make a home for one another in our branches. To unfurl and break open is at once a vulnerable and generous thing to do. Inside the shell, we feel safe and secure. We have the control of our edges. No one can get in, and we cannot get out. But we're called to more. We are called to breaking open. I've seen that pretty strongly here at South Church, the feeling of breaking open, the feeling of being called to more. Someone once told me that they often feel their hard exterior keeping them isolated and shut down. But this place, whenever they find their way here, they're helping, whether they're helping with the youth group or they're teaching Sunday school, the youth of our church causes their heart to break open. Their saying is actually that their Grinch heart grows 3 sizes whenever they find their way here to South Church. I've had that experience too. I wonder how many of us might have shown up with a Grinch heart and left with a heart so much bigger than we had when we walked in. Dear ones, when we come together and see one another and make space for each other, our hearts crack open. Our spirit can unfurl, and we grow in new ways. Church is the place where we can break free, where we can grow. And dear ones, you already have. In the years I've spent at South Church, I've had the profound gift of watching people break open and expand and find their passions. I've seen the ways the kingdom of God is alive here in this congregation, in this town we live in. I've seen the ways this congregation can offer the right amount of protection and nutrients and challenge and care for trees to grow within each of us. I've seen the kingdom of heaven unfurl as we baptize babies right here in our sanctuary, as 80-year-olds smile and weep as a small child brings them communion. I've seen our hearts break open when we sing a favorite hymn, when we hear a young person play their French horn in public for the first time. I've seen millennials discover beauty and complexity and joy in Christian community that they might not have expected or known existed before coming here. I've seen people face their fears and speak in the pulpit or ring a handbell or play their French horn, like we just said, or play the piano or preach. I've seen youth pick up power tools adults discover for the first time just how inspiring our teenagers can be. I've seen you all visit each other in hospitals, bring flowers to doorsteps, deliver Advent boxes, fill trunks with food for the Pop the Trunk food drive. In all of these ways, we are breaking open. In all of these ways, we're leaving a little bit of room for the Spirit of God to come in and invite us to be more than we are on our own. In all of these ways, we're releasing these hard shells. We're letting go of our fears and our worries. And we're letting the community of God, the kingdom of heaven, usher us in to more than we are on our own. And praise God for that. Praise God that we are not left as the seeds on our own, but we are invited to grow here. That the church is a place where there is room for you to try new things, where there is room to show up as you are right now and to be someone totally different next week. Praise God for that. I've seen this church unfurl. I've seen how the breaking of our individual hearts here in this congregation can grow trees tall and broad and beautiful, where in the branches people can find safe space to live and grow. And I've seen the seeds planted in our young people bear good fruit in all the places they live now. Last month, I had a conversation with one of our young adults who grew up here at South Church and recently moved to another part of the country. They wanted a faith community where they were to go to where they were going, but they weren't sure they would find a place just like South Church.
And I'm not sure that they will find a place just like South Church, because we are not in control of how the seed breaks open. We are not in control of how the kingdom of God will unfurl. Any community is different. And thank God for that, because we all find our place in different ways. But I have to say, the seed you planted in this young adult, her growing tree of safety and community and inspiration, is already helping her find her way. She is already creating community. She is already creating a home wherever she is and providing safe space for others to rest. The tree that you all planted within her, as the branches extend, there are birds of the air that find their way to her that are safe with her. And the reason she can do that is because of the lessons you all poured into her, the love that you shared with her, the ways that she was taught to grow with mercy and justice here in this space. South Church, this is a place where we can provide blessing and nutrients and pressure and growth to each other so we might break open. So we might not be afraid to leave our hard exterior, so we might not be afraid to be more than we are on our own. As we grow together, as we keep growing, we don't yet know how we will break open or where the seeds of the mustard plant will spread. We don't yet know who we will be, but we do know that we are called to more than our shells. We are called to more than our hard exteriors, than our traditions and our expectations and our fears that keep us small and hard and isolated. This day, whatever hard exterior you're holding, whatever shell you're grasping onto to keep you safe, I pray this day we will let it go. We will break open and release. I pray this day that we will allow ourselves the grace to open up to the one who connects us, who roots us, who lets us grow taller every day, who lets us extend in branches that make space for one another, that make shade for one another. I pray we will let our hearts soften, that our hardened hearts, the places that there's not a lot of wiggle room, will soften, where we'll find room to grow. We don't know yet what the growing will look like. We don't yet know where the seeds will spread, but we do know that the movement of God, the unfurling of God's justice and love, cannot and will not be stopped. The mustard plant, this tenacious plant that grows wherever it is planted, it is not done growing. We are not done growing. No human effort to dig out the roots or tamp down the flowers will ever succeed. The ever-flowing love of God will grow in our hearts, will break us open, if only we would let go of our exteriors, if only we would release and trust. Amen.